How to customize WordPress 2017 theme. Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Amul and this is TapTube. In this video, I'm going to talk about the new features that you get with WordPress 4.7 and 2017 theme. So this is WordPress 4.7 Vaughn, which was recently launched, and it's presenting 2017 theme. Because the 2017 has come. So what do you get with 2017 theme and WordPress 4.7? This is what you get. This is 2017 theme. It looks on the desktop and this is how it looks on the mobile. Okay. And what do you get? So this is what you get. You get four sections on the home page. You can also upload a video on your header, and these are the attraction of 2017 theme. Okay, there are few. So this is the video header that I was talking about. Second thing is edit shortcuts, that you get edit shortcuts. So when you click on the shortcuts, it directly takes you to the area where you have to do the editing. Okay, so edit shortcut is there. Smooth menu building, you would realize that. Custom CSS, a good thing. PDF thumbnail preview, and here you can choose your preferred language for your dashboard. Okay, so 4.7, the WordPress 4.7 comes with REST API endpoints for posts, comments, terms, users, meta, and settings. So this is the best part of 4.7, and it is going to make it more customizable, and so this is going to be good for the developers, WordPress developers, and it's good for if you want to connect with other applications built with any language. So this is the best part of WordPress 4.7 and WordPress 2017 theme. It's just awesome start. And so now I'm going to take you to our website, which is running on 4.7 and WordPress 2017. So this is the website. I just uploaded this video, which is just 2 MB, and it's a very small light video which is running very fast. Okay, so this is the home page for 2017. This is how it may look like, and this is the menu, which is a flat yet very dashing, I don't know what you call it. And then you get a arrow if you click on here, this goes on top, and then you get the feature image for the first section. So on home page you get four sections. Okay, for each section you can promote any of your pages and make sure that every page has that feature image. If you do not have that feature image, this will not appear here on the scrolling down when you're going to scroll down. Okay, so you get the second image, then the second featured page, then you get the third image, that's the featured image, and then featured page. Okay, in each section. And then you get here on the bottom, you get the footer area. This is a very simple footer. You get nothing but these two, and I just added these custom menu and the widget from through the Jetpack. Okay, so this is what you get. It's a very simple design. If you look at here, I would suggest you do some customization, make it better as per whatever the theme, the concept, the website concept or theme could be for your website. So make some changes. Alright, so this is it. Now let me quickly go ahead and show you how does it look like on a blog page. Okay, so this is how it's gonna look like on a particular page. So this is my blog for this website. It has two columns, this is the main content area, and then the other one is site. the sidebar, and you get, what do you get here? You get on the bottom to the buttons, right? You get the buttons here, next and previous. If you go on a different page, let's see, I want to go on here, on dulls, you get similar thing, but the image goes on top. So here, this is how it looks like. You get the category and everything here, next and previous, everything same, okay? Now I'm going to show you how you can make some customization to your WordPress 2017 theme, okay? So we are actually going to customize the WordPress theme now, okay? So we are in the dashboard area or admin area. Here you simply go on to appearance, go on to customize. You can make changes, whatever changes you want here as well. You can create header that takes you to the same area, okay? Menu, this is created over here. So I have just a few menus here. I will definitely show you. So these are the menu that I have. Three menus, bottom, main, and social. Widget, if you want to see the widget, okay. So these are, this is the sidebar and the header, footer one. I've got custom menu, footer two. I've got categories, okay. And this is it. You can simply drag anything that you want to wherever, sidebar, footer two, footer one, wherever you want to simply. If you want to put a sidebar here, a calendar on the bottom, you can definitely do so. Okay, so that's it. Custom menu, wherever you want to create, you can do so. All right, now I'll go to the customize area. Here I will talk about few changes that you can make on your website, okay? So everything is the same. Site title, you can put your site title, tagline, display if you want to display it. Take the checkbox, site icon, yeah, 512 into 512, make sure that is okay. You can also put a logo, so logo will appear here. You make sure that's 250 into 250 pixels, not more than 32 MB, but make sure it's lighter, okay? So that's done. Site identity, the logo will appear just above this. So this is a shortcut. If you click on here, that goes here. So wherever you are you, wherever, whenever you see that shortcut, if you click on that, that takes you to the actual position where you can make some customization, okay, area. So if I click here, this takes me to, okay, let me just click it. Okay, I did not work, I don't know why. Okay, it's working. Sitemap, because this is a widget thing. Okay, it did here. Footer two, this is footer one, it's not working. Okay, no problem. So this is working, all right. This is the main menu, social menu, read by category, footer two, footer one doesn't work. Okay, no problem. Okay, so we are going to talk about the colors. So you get three options in 2017 theme like others. So light will be light, the white one. Everything is light, white. Second one is the dark. This totally changes everything, right? This is the dark one, dark theme. You also get a custom one, so you can customize it. You can choose two colors. So background will be the white, okay? However, if you want to change these buttons, you simply change the color and you'll see that changes here on the top, okay? So I'll keep it as it is, slightly darker. This is for the title. Header text color, this is for the site title. If you see here, if you make any changes over here, that changes. Okay, so this is it. I'll say that I like this color. Okay, I'll go back. The header media, that's the change in 2017. So whatever you upload, video or image, that has to be 2000 into 1200 pixels. And make sure the size is the smaller the better. So to change or upload a new video, you simply click here. You'll get upload video first. And then if you have already uploaded, you'll get to change it. Okay, that has to be maximum 32 MB. And also that has to be in MP4 format only, okay? Click on here, select the video, and you are done. This is how you can upload image from here bottom. Okay, so this is it. If you have to upload a video, that's really good. Menu thing we have already covered. It's very simple, like the old one. The only change in 2017, you will see the social menu on the bottom. The widget is definitely the same thing. Edit pages, obviously the same thing. You can choose two pages, one for the front page, whatever page you want. The second, the post page. I definitely want the blog page of my website to be a post page. Theme options. This is the new thing that you get with 2017 theme. You get four sections I was talking about. Section one content, section two content, front page. You see, front page, section three content, and four. So you can choose four pages that you want to promote on your front page. Also, you can put two columns if you want, but I would like to keep it in just one column. So what it is going to look like in two columns, this will, you know, go to the right, and the site, the page name will appear here. Okay, but I would like to keep it as this one, the first one column. Okay, one column page. And then you can choose the pages. Make sure every page that you're going to choose for each section has a feature image, otherwise the image will not appear here. Okay, that's it. That's it for front page layout. Okay. Okay, the last thing comes here, additional CSS. So any CSS change you want to make on the same theme, you do not want to make any child theme, you can definitely do so. So that will be covered in the next video. Just to give you an idea of basically how you can change something, just select the elements. Let's say you want to change this background for this footer. So this is the Chrome browser. I'll right click on here and click on inspect. So this is the footer, right, the wrap for the footer. This is already selected. If you make any changes over here, that will be the change. So background, I want to choose whatever I want, okay? This is how you can make changes. That's the change you want. And once that's done, you simply copy it, this one, copy it, and make sure you address the same class or ID. So simply, I'm not sure what was that. Okay, so it was this one. I'll better use this one. Okay, just double click on it, copy it, put it here. Okay, and then you go here, make sure you put in the background color. Let's say I want to do black. This is what it's going to look like. Okay, so this is how you can make changes to, and then save it, whatever changes you want to make, and save it, and you are done. Okay, so this was an idea. This is how you can make some CSS, additional CSS customization to your WordPress 2017 theme. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, share, and subscribe. By the way, if you liked anything in this video, please leave in the comment. Thank you so much again. Have a good day, guys. Bye-bye.